and sisters, subhanAllah, many people go upstairs and think that is the original Masjid al-Aqsa. Whilst it is above the original Masjid al-Aqsa, so it still has the same reward, but you have to come downstairs, and it is known as Al-Aqsa Al-Qadim. And this is where you can visualize the original Masjid al-Aqsa. So, subhanAllah, these are the original pillars, as we see, of Al-Masjid al-Aqsa. And it is narrated that these are the original bricks that was put together by the jinn in the time of Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam. As we learn in the Quran al-Kareem that the jinn were helping Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam construct this building, and the death came to Sayyidina Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed him to sit leaning on his stick, and the jinn thought that he was alive, and they completed the construction. So these are the original rocks and pillars that were put together by the jinn in the time of Sayyidina Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam. And the most exciting part here is this mihrab. This is the mihrab where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam stood on the night of Mi'raj. And that is where Habib Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wasallam led all the anbiya in salah. So you could imagine now, Sayyidina Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, Yahya alayhi salatu wasalam, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam, Sulaiman alayhi salam, and the galaxy of 124,000 anbiya making salah in this area behind our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam. And not far from here, we are told this is the mihrab of Sayyidina Zakariya alayhi salatu wasalam. That when Sayyidina Zakariya alayhi salatu wasalam witnessed what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam, he entered his mihrab. And this is where he entered the mihrab and asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant him a son. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered his dua and granted him the great Yahya alayhi salatu wasalam.